Let me give you a sense of optimism in terms of the curve in California bending. It is bending, but it's also stretching.
Governor Newsom sensing a turn for the better with what he decided the state had more than its fair share of ventilators and donated 500 to several states that need them right now. All right, let's bring our panel back in. Jim Veros, Humberto Gomez Jr. And guys, I want to start with this here. Governor Newsom pledging this week he's going to find a way to help undocumented workers with monetary relief, something Congress obviously, as you know, did not do when they rolled out that phase three of the stimulus package. This is going to come obviously with lots of controversy here. How should this be handled? Should it be allowed? And Jim, I'm going to start with you.
Well, I find it difficult to understand how we're going to deem farm labor essential. This is a business deal. We're making them stay in the fields and pick and deeming them essential, giving them paperwork to say that they're essential, but then we're not going to treat them as folks that are here that need help. I find that very, very difficult to understand. So listen, people can take a stance and you know, start a nice immigration debate after this is all done. But right now, we need folks to obviously be picking our food and helping us grow it. So if we're going to make them stay in the fields and be susceptible to this virus, I think we can go a little bit out of our way to try to help them out a little bit.
Yeah, and the other thing here, and I want to make it clear, you know, Governor Newsom didn't delegate between just undocumented or undocumented citizens who do pay taxes. There are two classifications there. Humberto, what do you say to that?
I would say that I'm glad Governor Newsom's taking this step because a lot of folks that are undocumented were not part of the, you know, the COVID-19 stimulus package. I have always known, specifically here in the Central Valley, that they've always have been essential. If you look at fresh produce, you look at basically the labor, over 90% is an undocumented workforce. Not just with fresh produce.
Wait. 90% of what? 90% of Fresno County?
Fresno County, in the Central Valley, in the state of California, Coachella Valley, Imperial Valley, all the whole agricultural areas of our state, and also within the dairy industry. Within the dairy industry, even the state of Idaho, a nice Republican state, even the Idaho Dairy Association was out there doing PR with their state, stating that, hey, my dairy workers are essential. And this language that the letters that they received stating that they're essential, but they're still not protected from deportation.
Humberto, and actually, Jim, I'll come to you and then Humberto back to you. I think the big question mark now is, well, who would pay for this? Is this a taxpayer-funded a stimulus package? Where does this come from? Jim, again,
here. And that's going to be up to the governor, right? I mean, obviously, we have emergency funds. This is why you have a rainy day fund. This is why you have a good relationship with federal aid, with other sorts of aid. I mean, if he's going to come out and say that there's a way to do this, then let's take a look at it. But when it comes to helping these folks out, there's got to be a way. If we're going to make them stay out there and say that they're going to be working for us so that we can not only feed ourselves, but also this is our main product that we sell in the valley. This is money. I mean, so listen, where's it going to come from? It might come from the taxpayers. And the taxpayers like being able to have the state make other money so that they don't have to raise their taxes.
Humberto, what do you say to this? And if taxpayers do pay for it, will there be a tax incentive at the end of the year for it?
I mean, how much of agriculture does this workforce generate for our economy? Mm-hmm. Okay, how much do they go to the markets? How much do they buy things? Do they do this or that? So obviously, to me, it's a no-brainer. They contribute an essential part of our economic power force. California would not be the fifth largest economy if it wasn't for the essential force of our migrant farm workers, undocumented, documented. And also, we fail to realize, too, that guess what? A lot of them have kids that are not in school as well. And a lot of those kids are American citizens. So guess what? They're entitled to a lot of benefits as well. So yeah, that hasn't looked upon yet.
It'll be interesting to see how this comes out, because obviously the assembly is going to get involved as well. Right. Guys, I want to move on to this. Ventilators. Governor Gavin Newsom donating 500 of them this last week to hotspots, specifically New Jersey, Louisiana, New York, 500 ventilators, where here in the Central Valley, we know that medical supplies as a whole are scarce. We haven't hit our peak here in the state, especially here in the Central Valley. Was this too soon to do? Humberto, I'll let you start.
Well, he probably had consultation with his health and human secretary, and they realized as well that, you know, and I think the nation's starting to realize that California is basically, it's a nation within the state. That's why Governor Newsom's gonna buy 200 million N95 masks. And so that's what he did out of the goodwill of California, to donate those ventilators where they're necessary.
All right, so let me take it a step further, because there's been this criticism out among, you know, obviously pundits who say that he's just doing this to set himself up for goodwill, as if he makes a run for the presidency down the road. Jim, any truth to that, or any sauce to that, if you will?
Yeah, probably, but I always love it when politicians accuse other politicians of playing politics. So, I mean, listen, everything is political. I do have to say, though, I'm wondering if Gavin Newsom did take some of this equipment and pass it on, because he did organize a number of states to go out and buy this equipment, and I'm sure they got a volume discount because it was more than just California. So I'm wondering if there was some sort of agreement between California and these other states to say, hey, when we purchase these, we'll go ahead and pass it on to you. But we need to have more than just California purchasing these, you know, this equipment from Hong Kong, China, other places. But I'm sorry, but this is why we're talking about this on Sunday.
Yeah. Well, guys, I got to leave it there. Always good to have you guys on. Happy Easter to you. And as always, stay safe.
Likewise.
Palm Sunday to the Greeks.
All right, up next, she's one of the most respected family doctors in the country, and she's in the heart of the pandemic now. Dr. Linda Gerges joins me exclusively from New Jersey next.